Slaughterhouse.
We're all gonna die slow, horrible deaths at the hands of an adorable little killing machine!
Slaughterhouse is pretty much what you'd expect. It's a horror comedy that takes a dumb premise and dials it up to 11 for some laughs. I am gonna spoil this one, even though it's new, cause... yeah, if I didn't, this review would be about 30 seconds. And I need your attention for longer than that. Not for any sinister reasons or anything.
Now... sink into the floor.
Wait.
Sink.
Let's get spooky. The movie starts off in Panama and we see a sloth get got by an alligator, but weirdly, we see the sloth climb out of the water totally fine, and the gator pops up out of the water and rolls over and we see three giant bloody claw marks in his belly. Cue the title screen, Slaughterhouse. Okay, yeah, this is gonna be dumb. We then jump to America and our main girl Emily is hanging out in the mall and a little dog runs from its owner. She catches it near an exotic wildlife dealer and he pitches selling her a pet. She says she belongs to a sorority and they wouldn't allow a dog. He says, what about a sloth? Oh, you mean the animal whose self-defense mechanism is to smell like absolute shit all day every day? Why wouldn't a sorority want something like that moving its slow ass around their shared living spaces? So she takes his card and bounces. At the sorority, we get introduced to our head bitch, I mean, House President Brianna. It's the start of a new, either year or semester at school, and every year or semester they have a vote on who's going to be the next president of the house. Emily desperately wants to get more attention and get a bigger social media following. By the way, this is a very heavy social media kind of movie. Every new character we even get vaguely introduced to, their social media profile picture pops up with their number of followers next to them to tell us their hierarchy of their social status. Brianna is top bitch with the most followers. Don't know why, she never shows any social media savvy or any reason why anyone even likes her. Emily realizes that she's never gonna get a bigger following or become president until she gets something to make her stand out and be special. So she slides into the DMs of the wildlife guy and agrees to get the sloth. At the guy's house, he takes the sloth out of her cage and he immediately gets attacked and killed by the thing. It's stupid easy how easy this sloth kills him. Emily comes by and doesn't see the owner, but sees the sloth wandering around. She hears some loud tiger noises in the back, and even though our sloth could obviously kill a Bengal tiger, she thinks it's not safe there, so she just takes him and goes, it's a sloth. He obviously would have been fine. She gets back to the sorority and everyone finds out about the animal. They all take a vote and it immediately becomes the new mascot. We get introduced to a few new characters like Zenny, who is basically a parody of a tomboy. She honestly is the worst part of the whole movie, like it's bad acting and bad dialogue. And there's Morgan, who is an animal rights activist who hates the idea of owning the sloth. The house is having a party and Emily feeds the sloth her pill. By the way, the sloth's name is Alpha. And then Emily leaves the room. Alpha starts wandering around and notices her computer is open. Okay, no fucking way. This thing immediately is able to master the computer. And she sees a picture of her, of Emily, with the wildlife guy and closes the laptop in anger and spits out her pill. The murders start one by one with one of Brianna's minions taking the sloth outside and leaving it there. Unfortunately for her, the sloth can teleport back into the house at the same time she got back there and slits her throat. Okay, sure. The next day we get a montage of the sloth randomly killing chicks in the house and getting away with it. Okay, yeah, 6 to 8 deaths in a house of like 2 dozen people. Who would notice such a thing? Alpha, being classic Alpha, is drinking beer and chilling by the pool with Zenny while the activist chick gets there and tries to take her back to the shelter. Emily fights back in protest, meanwhile Alpha grabs Morgan's phone and throws it in the middle of the road. Cue a car running over Morgan. What? This is a residential road that not only leads up to the house, but it's also like in the back of the pool. It looks like she got hit by a car going 45. Morgan gets sent to the hospital. The next day, it's voting time for the new president of the house. Our girl Emily gets the win, obviously, but Alpha has more pressing matters to deal with, so she steals a fucking car. can't. Oh, man. Okay, so she steals the car, goes to the hospital, takes a quick death selfie with Morgan, and then smothers her with a pillow. Oh, I almost forgot. On the way to the hospital, Alpha is smart enough to know, like, to stop at red lights, but not smart enough to not get pulled over by the cops for speeding. But she stops at the hospital, and the cop opens the car door, and no one is there. Fucking useless. So Alpha makes it back to the house, fuck knows how. Maybe she teleported, maybe she drove back, I have no idea. But Alpha turns into Jason Voorhees and starts to go absolute ape shit on the sorority sisters. We get a cheap shower kill where she electrocutes 90% of the sorority sisters. The house mother, Miss Mayflower, is able to get in a few licks and has a heart-to-heart with Emily, which is probably the funniest part of the whole movie. She's saying, like, her entire life goal was to be made president of the house, and even though she's bleeding to death, Emily's like, "What?" But without saying anything? You thought we would just randomly vote to make you president? That's a terrible goal. You're dumb. So it's just down to four characters, and our sloth takes in a few bullets to the chest and also a sword through the torso, like center torso. But remember, it's Jason Voorhees, so that's not good enough. Emily has a one-on-one with the sloth and stabs a tiara into its skull, and then she shoots it 3 times, and right before the finishing blow, Alpha cries out for Panama and then dies. We jump to a year later and Brianna and Emily are friends. Even though Emily went back to save her twice during the slaughter, Brianna takes the first chance every time she got to bail on Emily.
You dumb bitch.
And that's pretty much the whole movie. So how was it? I think Dan Merle said it best. The first half, or at least half hour of the movie, is actually pretty boring. It's only until the sloth starts to learn modern technology in a matter of seconds that things start to get, like, really stupid and fun. With these kinds of movies, it's almost expected to have a huge amount of creative violence and blood in it, but they're actually pretty cheap on that stuff here. I don't know what it's like in Zombievers or Black Sheep, but I am pretty sure those movies had buckets of blood in them, and this one just doesn't. Also, with these low-grade, dumb premise horror movies, you'd also expect a lot of nudity and or dirty jokes, but those aren't here either. It's also kind of weird how there is absolutely nothing special about this sloth. There's no disease or possession, there's nothing. Literally nothing is special about this sloth, so it's safe to assume all sloths could not only get away with murdering 20 chicks, but also master driving a car and using phones and computers in seconds. Overall, this movie is a one and done. It's also not funny or fun enough for me to give it a strong recommendation unless you want to watch a dumb over-the-top movie. My only recommendation is that you play on your phone or do something for the first half hour, then give the movie your attention, because it's gonna get stupid. Tomorrow is Talk to Me, but I've already done that this year, so give it a watch if you haven't already, and stay spooky.